Southwest Florida, I told you. Everybody was dressed all up, but you didn't know the app was party, baby. Listen to the background. Here's what we got. Let me paint the picture for you. We're at the Alpha's Black and Gold Ball. We got people in the background jamming. We got Robert Norris right here, who's been in Alpha Phi Alpha fraternity for 50 years. Longer than I was alive.
Don't rub it in.
Hey, Robert. When you first pledged, man, did you ever think one day it'd be 50 years, man? You just can't imagine that, huh?
No, but you know, I pledged. It took me 18 months in the pledge period in Indiana State University in Terre Haute. I started pledging in February 1965, and I went over in May of 66, so it was almost 18 months. But, you know, back then we did the hazing and everything, so once you got through that, you knew you was being Alpha, or Kappa, or Q, or Sigma the rest of your life. So it was a good feeling.
You get to tell some of those war stories, man.
Some serious war stories. But you know what? It built character, man. People see one side of it, but there's another side that deals with the character building as well.
I think, what was that you guys carry around? You carry around a sphinx in your hand? What was it?
It's the sphinx itself?
Right.
Right. So, because we were the first black intercollegiate fraternity, but we were not the first black fraternity. You had the Boulé. Most people don't know that. That were the first black fraternity, but they were black professionals. We were the first black ones in terms of intercollegiate undergraduate, you know. And after that, we had the others coming by, which was necessary.
And you guys carried that opening act on the college campuses with great distinction, which was the catalyst for what we have today with all these Greek letter fraternities.
Yeah, you know, some people talk about the Greek letter fraternities, but the Divine Nine, Alphas, Kappa, Qs, Sigmas, Iotas, AKAs, Deltas, Sigma, Gamma, Rho's, Zeta, Phi, Babies. The bottom line is we're brothers and sisters as a whole. There's a reason why we were established on campus, and that reason was to survive in the racist environment that was on campus at the time.
And possess a lot of political, social, and economic strength in terms of how the power that the Divine Nine has in American culture now shaping elections of presidents and a whole lot of other social events by coming together under one accord.
Yeah, so many members of the Divine Nine, it was this leadership, and that's what it's about. Leadership, work in the community, and the most important thing is we give back. It's a service, we're all service oriented because we have to bring those along with us, and that's exactly what we had to do.
What's your thoughts about the scholarship recipient tonight? She seemed to have wowed the crowd.
This scholarship recipient, we've given out several scholarships over the years. They're all bright, but this one has something else about herself. She has personality. She's gonna achieve what she wants to achieve. She's a young lady that was born in Haiti, came to this country, and really just did a good job. And that's thanks to her parents and family members. And it's thanks to herself, because she had a work ethic, I believe, that showed. And that personality of hers is outstanding.
What are some of the things that you take away from being in a fraternity so distinguished as Alpha Phi Alpha for 50 years? What are some things that just kind of stand out, two or three things?
Well, one is the brothers that I've met over the years. The other piece is it helped to develop leadership, because all of us have to be involved in some aspect of the fraternity as an officer and so on down the line. Each of us got that chance, and we do it. The other piece is that we relate to not only the Alphas, but the other fraternities and so on. And we're, like I said, we're part of the family. The leadership that we have, the success that we've experienced is something else. And you know, I'll be an Alpha till I die, but more important, I'll be a Divine Nine member till I die.
Now, you're an educator too as well, right? You're a retired educator?
Yes, I'm a retired principal out of New York City. I was just a kid from the South Bronx that went to school in Indiana, came back, and my commitment was to my people, period. And I retired as a principal in Brooklyn 15 years ago. It just seemed like it was yesterday. And the commitment is always there for our young people in terms of education.
What can we expect from Alpha for the rest of the year? And I know we'll be rolling right up on Dr. King Day before you know it.
Oh, the Dr. King thing is our brand right here. And we will be rolling up there very quickly. But at the same time, we're still pushing for mentoring programs. And because, again, service is extremely important with us. So it's the Dr. King. We have our own annual drive in December. That's when we were established and so on. And again, we try to have some fun in the process as well.
Final question. What has been the response from the community and from people who have been attending your Black and Gold Ball? What has been the response from them?
It's always been a positive response, you know, and we get quite a bit of support from the people in the community. And the money that we earn from these activities, we definitely put it right back into our young people in terms of scholarships.
Congratulations on 50 years, bro.
Thanks again, man.
We'll be right back. Phi Beta Sigma, Alpha Phi Alpha. If it wasn't for Alpha, there would be no Phi Beta Sigma. These guys started it all. We'll be right back.